This is Mission Qualphone, a monthly podcast that takes you inside the workings of our company, but not just the ins and outs of business. We look at the ideas and insights that make Qualphone truly unique. As a company, we are committed to being the best and making each person's life better. Join us as we get to know and learn from people from across the organization. What's their story? What have they learned? And how do they live out Qualphone's mission? Welcome to Mission Qualphone. Hello and welcome to Mission Qualphone. I'm Jeremy Lunnan here with my partner, Marisol Sanchez. Hi, Marisol. How are you?
I am well, Jeremy. How are you?
I'm doing great. Surviving, barely surviving this quarantine that we're going through. How have you been doing during all of this?
It's just a strange time. I don't know, what week are we? Week seven?
It's been a long time, 7 or 8 weeks, I'm sure. Yeah.
So it's even weird to answer that question because it's kind of day to day. It's just a whole new experience. So I feel great right now because I love my job. I love what I do. Mm-hmm. We've been busier than ever. And what we've done since COVID-19 has been kind of amazing.
Yeah, I agree. And Lyman, who's our guest today, we'll bring him on here in a minute. He and I were talking about that just a minute ago, is how we've both been very busy. So it just kind of depends. You know, some folks are in this mode that they're, depending on what their role is things have really slowed down for them. Other folks are really busy. And in our case, you know, as individuals, all three of us, and as a company, we've been very busy.
I will say that one of the best things about the last 7 weeks has been my job.
Yeah. Yeah.
Has been my job. I'm grateful for it and for what the company is doing, what everyone's doing. Everyone's really just done an amazing job. I mean, we've moved, I don't even know how many thousand at this point. And you were a big part of that with the training videos.
Oh yeah. I've been very busy with that. As many folks have. Anytime you are doing something so big, and I mean, we're talking thousands and thousands and thousands of employees that have been moved to working from home. That's just a big undertaking. So it's, and you know, there have been hiccups, there have been bumps as there would be with anything like that. But to do it as fast as we've done it has been pretty incredible. And that's been exciting to see.
As a human being, not as an employee, you're kind of like, you know, when is this going to end? When does the new normal begin?
Will there be a new normal? Yes, exactly.
Are we shaking hands? Are we blowing up birthday candles? You know, I don't know. It's an exciting time to be alive, but it can be very anxious time as well. So to ask how you're doing is kind of more of a complicated question.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, for sure.
Well, I think that's a perfect time to introduce our guest, though, because I know he has a lot to tell us, and I'm excited to have him on.
I am too. I've known Lyman for a few years now, and have had the opportunity to be with him in different locales around the world, and that's always been fun. And he's always great to talk to. Lyman, how are you, sir?
I am good. I appreciate you guys having me on.
Are we not going to share his last name?
Oh, I guess we could. We're talking to Lyman Beatty. And Lyman, give us your official title, just so people know who we're talking to.
My official title is I am the Higher Education Manager for the Americas. So that just encompasses the United States, Mexico, Guyana, Costa Rica.
Jeremy, so I got to meet Lyman at Summit. You know, we referred to Summit in our previous episodes, and he and I were working at the same table. We were doing, it wasn't a team building exercise. It was the mission department and the people's office, which is otherwise known as HR outside of Qualphone. I have to keep reminding myself of that, Jeremy, by the way,
right.
That people outside of our company listen to the podcast. So
if we talk about the person's office, they're like, what is that? What is
yeah.
That? Yeah. And that's the HR or HD department, depending on yes. who's used to calling it. Yeah.
So these two departments were going through this exercise, and I was lucky enough to participate. And I have never been to a corporate event and a exercise like that that ended up with so many people speaking so passionately about the company mission, the employees, everything. I mean, people were in tears. Some people actually in tears of gratitude. So do you remember that, Lyman?
I do. It was a great working session. It was a great, like, just, I would call them mini, like, focus groups that we were doing. And we're just establishing strategies to better market Qualphone to the marketplace. And I think it was a unique opportunity. The meshing of minds was really unique. And it was fun to hear everybody's passion for this company and what we have to offer.
Now, Lyman, you mentioned your title, Higher Education Manager. Now, I have never worked for a company, a business. I've actually worked for two different universities, but I'm talking outside of academia. I've never worked for a company that has a higher education manager. And we're going to get to that in a sec.
But I want to throw this out just for context, because I'm not sure everyone is aware of this and how important higher education is to the leaders of our company. Our founder, Alfonso Gonzalez, he comes from a really tiny town in Mexico, and his family literally sold their home to pay for Alfonso's college education. And he went to school. He's an electrical engineer and has an MBA. So obviously higher education is very important to Alfonso, our founder. And Mike Morrow, our CEO, same type of scenario. He paid his way through college working full time. So both of these men have demonstrated their commitment to education, and obviously it's very important to them personally and very important to the company. I just wanted to make sure that we all kind of understood that. Now, Lyman, I would love to hear your story.
What brought you to Qualphone? Tell us a bit about your background and how you found yourself here.
So I came to Qualphone actually just over 4 years ago, last April. I came from kind of the nonprofit world. I worked for a local nonprofit here in Colorado that worked with disadvantaged youth and families. And I really enjoyed that role. I was a youth program director, oversaw our youth programs. I enjoyed that role. However, like in nonprofit world, you kind of are limited in scope and what you can do and where you can progress to. So I always wanted an opportunity to take those skills and that passion and use it for quote unquote greater good, right? So I had a unique opportunity and a mutual friend, someone who worked for Qualphone at the time, let me know about this position they're having and the mission of Qualphone, and that they had this position coming up that was called a mission coordinator. So he encouraged me to apply because he knew what I was doing with my current role for the nonprofit and thought I'd be a great candidate for that position. So I applied and interviewed and got the job. And the rest has kind of been a journey, and we can go into that. But like, that's kind of where I came from.
This is my second tenure at Qualphone, and it took me a long time to really understand the department mission. So Lyman, how do you describe the mission department?
Well, for me, I always describe it, having come from the nonprofit community, there's so many similarities between what we do with the mission and what we were doing in the nonprofit world. So I always look at it as that, you know, nonprofits were created for the enrichment and betterment of other people, for a cause, for a purpose, to build and lift people up. And I see us in the mission doing the same thing for the people of Qualphone and the communities that we serve. And it was something I'd never seen in the private sector before. So that was one thing that really drew me to the position, was like, wow, this is really awesome, because I get to do what I'm doing now, but now I get to do it with a greater budget, a greater scope, a greater reach. And that was something that drew me to the position immediately, and more opportunity, right? To expand my gifts and my potential in different avenues. And it has, from where I started and to where I am today, it's grown me exponentially in different ways. And I'm already in like a different position from when I started. So never thought I would take that avenue, but it's a natural fit for me. So.
Yeah. I love how you described it, because I get flustered when I try to describe it, but it's a whole department, a fully funded department that is dedicated to the personal improvement of not only its employees, but of the communities where we work. Anyone, I mean, outside of our communities, I mean, any opportunity that we can help anyone, the company has a whole department dedicated to it.
Absolutely. It's a great way to say it.
I see it in the literature. Let me explain it this way. Like, I see it in the literature with Maslow's hierarchy of needs, like that a company, and if you don't know what that is, Google it. But if a company is sitting around thinking about the improvement of its employees, of its clients, of anyone and everyone, it's just amazing. And, you know, in that meeting that you and I had that we were in Mexico City, that's what I came out of that, you know, meeting, realizing how many people had been touched. Like, you know, in the first episode with Mike Morrow, he says we're mission obsessed.
Marisol, as you know, our full mission statement, a big part of that is to help as many individuals as possible pursue their total vocation. And that, to me, from a business, is a unique standpoint. And Lyman's role is a testament to that commitment to help people build their total vocation. He's dedicated to higher education programs here at Qualifone. So Lyman, here's your chance, right? Here's your big moment to tell us about higher ed programs here at Qualifone. Tell us what that means and how an individual can pursue their total vocation here at Qualifone.
Yeah, so higher education here at Qualifone is definitely a unique department within the mission. Not many companies will necessarily establish a part of the company that wants to see people grow that possibly takes them away from the company, right, and causes turnover, but mm-hmm. Qualifone does that. We have this area that we want to see people, whatever their passion in life is, we want to see them going for that. And so higher education is just that. It gives them an opportunity to start studying, to learn, to improve their skills so that they can go off and do what they're meant to do in this world, this life, so that they can be achieving their total vocation. So we have many different programs. The programs have grown over the years. The first few programs we have are free programs that we offer to all employees, and that is our basically higher education. We have a skill development program that we source through LinkedIn Learning. That's a program that a participant can get into and get 3-month access to LinkedIn Learning's platform. And on there, there's over thousands of courses that they can study from in various business-related topics, whether it's learning new skills, whether it's learning project management, whether it's learning how to be a better photographer or something like that. It's a way for them to improve those skills that might prepare them for the next role or the next opportunity, right? And they get 3-month access. And that beauty of that is we don't go in and tell them or create a program for them to study. They can study whatever they want. They can do as many hours as they want. We do have a minimum requirement, but other than that, that's it. I mean, we ask them to go out and they study what their heart is passionate for. The other program we have, we source, is called our specialization program. And this is kind of taking that learning to the next level. It's taking what someone is passionate for and giving it more focused coursework. We source this program through Coursera. Coursera is one of the top online platforms for over 150 of the world's top universities. And all these courses that are on there are prepared and taught through various universities. So when someone takes a Coursera specialization, they're taking a course from either Stanford University or Pittsburgh University or the University of Colorado. The courses are endless. So, but why I say it's the next step is maybe you start in skill development and you learn that you have a passion for numbers and accounting. Now you can go to and take a specialization, and this is going to be a more focused courses where it's going to give you 5 to 6 courses on accounting so that you walk away with a greater base knowledge for that accounting principles, accounting, what accounting job would be like. And so now you have this certificate from, say, Duke University that you've taken this accounting specialization. And you can put that on your resume and go apply for entry-level accounting position with that background knowledge. So it's something that, or it may prepare you for to move from an agent role or a role that you're in currently and move into a different department within Qualifone. And if that's the case, that's great. If not, and takes you away from Qualifone, we're still happy and we're ecstatic because we lived our mission and you're going off to do what you want to do.
I think the distinction, because I've worked for companies that they gave educational opportunities in different ways, but biggest difference I can sense is how important education is, period, but then to make that available to anyone who wants it. Mm-hmm. There's a real push for that.
Yeah. And the beauty of those two programs is you don't have to be employed with the company for very long. We just need you to be out of training. Once you're out of training, you're eligible to start those programs. You don't have to stay. Most companies do things for education that they, for their employees that have been there a year or 6 months at minimum, right? Where this is, you know, once you're out of training and you're on the production floor and in your role, you can sign up and start participating in these programs. So you can start improving your skills right away. And I think that's a very unique aspect. Also, most companies who have educational opportunities are preparing just their employees for different roles within their company or to be better at their current job. And that's not necessarily what we're doing here. And that's not what we want. We want people to be just better at whatever they want to be better at.
Yeah, I say they want us to be the best versions of ourselves, like the best human beings we can be.
Correct.
So is there another level?
And then, finally, I think the biggest and best one we have is our Rochat School of Business Partnership. And that is, we have online degree programs that people can go back to school and get if they're missing, you know, maybe a bachelor's degree or want to get a master's degree. They can do that through our Rochat partnership. And the really cool thing is we have with them is that it's 100% online. All the courses are asynchronous, which means that you don't have to be online going through them at any certain time. Like you have a class time every Wednesday at 7 p.m. This is a weekly class schedule that you can tailor to your life. We definitely designed these programs along with Rochat with the full-time Qualphone employee in mind. We wanted them to have that work-life balance so that they don't have to give up their lives necessarily in order to go back to school and reach that goal of getting their degree or master's degree. So our employee tuition discount agreement is second to none in the industry, I think. I mean, we have discounts for our employees that make everything really, really affordable, next to nothing when you do a cost analysis from other degrees and other universities. And this is available to not just employees, but their family members as well. And that tuition reduction agreement is extended to them, the family members, in addition to that.
Lyman, how many people have taken advantage of these higher ed programs?
Since 2017 to date, we are just under 7,000 participants. And the cool thing also is year over year, we've seen our enrollments grow each year. So we've had a very positive response from everyone.
That's incredible. Can you tell us a bit about the Stairway program? Because that's an interesting concept as well, too, that I've never seen in a company. So can you share with us what the Stairway program is?
Stairway is a unique program that I've never seen any company take on. I think this particular program is cool because it's not necessarily in our higher education department's program. It's more of like a mission as a whole, where it's pulled a lot of pieces together, and a company as a whole has pulled a lot of pieces together to allow people a career pathing, sort of, so to speak. So Stairway is a 52-step program that anybody can start in the company. You don't have to apply for it. You can just go to mystairway.org and apply and get started. The purpose behind Stairway is for people really to discover what they're passionate about. So when we talk total vocation, people may not understand or have an idea of what they want to do in life or for that job or what they're really meant to do. So Stairway is a great way to start learning about yourself through these steps, learning about new career opportunities, learning about new higher education opportunities, and then going off and getting mentored by people within the company, out of the company. It's a really cool program.
Is it kind of like it's like self-help a little bit? Like if you want to kind of dig in deeper to how to improve your life? Because I felt like it was more than just education, but I could be wrong because I haven't done it.
No, it is. It is because, I mean, in the beginning, you're going to do a lot. In the start of the program, you do some self-assessments to learn, you know, your communication styles and who you best work with and how you what job you're best suited for based on your personality type. So you do learn, you do start off learning more about yourself, and then you go through steps on how to, okay, you've just established that you're more introverted and you're this type of excommunicator, and these are the roles that you're best suited for. And then you can go in and start learning about those roles and see if anything really stands out to you. And you go, once you start reading and learning about these different positions or jobs, then you can go in and learn about that. And it can lead you to higher education in that, okay, I realize now using my accounting analogies, like, okay, I learned that I really love numbers and I like to do figure problems out. And this is a position that is suited for that, but I've never taken any accounting courses and I don't know how to work with Excel or anything like that. So then you can flip that and you can start using the skill development program to learn more about accounting principles and things like that and start improving those skills so you can become better suited for that job and then move on to, you know, and then through the steps, then you can say, okay, there's opportunities at Qualphone for accounting, right? We're a large corporation. We have many accounting positions and here's some leaders and mission leaders in accounting and maybe I can reach out to them and start mentoring and asking questions. And that's cool because there's a mentor phase of the stairway that you will start reaching out and talking with leaders within the company and how did you get to that position or what did you learn or study to get to where you are and how did you get there? And then, so I think that's really unique in the Stairway program is that it wants you to reach out to, you know, if it means you have to reach out to Mike Morrow, our CEO, because that's where you want to be someday to start a relationship and ask some questions, it encourages you to do that. So the Stairway is definitely, and each step builds on itself, right? And it's designed
for- There's 52 of them?
Yeah, which sounds like a lot, but some steps are really fast. Some do take more time. It really is up to the user, end user, to take as long or as go as slow or as fast as they want to, right? It was designed to do some to be a slow process and to get the full benefit of it, you know, take up to 3 years. So you're not necessarily really dropping everything to get through these steps as fast as possible. Because if I say, if you started the Stairway and you tried to get through in a month, you're not getting the full benefit, right?
Right. I think the 52 steps, it was geared towards a year. You know, I think that was the idea, is it was supposed to take a year in a perfect world. But to Lyman's point, some people get through it a little quicker. Some people take a little more time. It's a journey of self-discovery. And I just wanted to say this from my angle, Lyman, I'm kind of over leadership training. The Stairway is a phenomenal opportunity for a leader to have bigger conversations with their employees. If I'm a manager and I know that my employee Marisol is in the Stairway program, man, that's just a natural conversation starter. Something that we can talk about. Well, Marisol, what are you finding out about yourself here? What do you think? What are your interests? I mean, it's just, there is so much power in that, putting that structure around self-discovery that a leader can leverage in having what I call those bigger conversations with their folks. I think it's.
I like how you framed it. I like that better than self-help. So it's self-discovery. So self-improvement.
Yeah. I've always encouraged when I talk about Stairway to sites and groups, I encourage supervisors to use that as a tool for their people, right? Like for personal and professional development, right? It's both. So when you have a person you're supporting and they're kind of always, they're chomping at the bit for more and more, but they're not sure what, but they just want to be like, I want to get to here. I want to do this. Or I'm, what else can I do? Stairway is a great tool to start and say, hey, I want you to go through these steps and we'll talk about them on a weekly basis and how you're doing and what you're finding out and discovering. And then how do I help you as a leader get to that next step or take advantage of the next step in the process?
Well, you convinced me. I'm going to sign up. So beware whoever is going to be mentoring me because I'm interested in a lot of different...
We'll be checking in on your progress, Marisol. How it's going.
Well, I'm a big believer in total vocation. I didn't even know that's what it was, but prior to coming back the second round for Qualphone, that's what I was trying to do in my own life, which, you know, was when I started podcasting. It's also when I helped start a nonprofit. I was trying to find all the things that I'm passionate about and do it. And you couldn't have made it up, but it led me also back to working in the BPO industry at Qualphone, which is kind of amazing.
And I love the way Lyman said it earlier. He said, and I'm paraphrasing, these might not be the exact words you said, Lyman, but he basically said, people learn to discover what they're meant to do. And those words are really powerful when you think about it. We're all meant to do something. And if we can help people get closer to that, even if it means they have to, or they decide to leave the company, or they if we can be part of that process and help people along that path towards their total vocation or doing what they were put on earth to do, man, that's an honor. I mean, that is an incredible thing to be a part of. And Lyman gets to do that every day in his job.
Yeah, I'm very blessed in my role. I'm very fortunate to work with a great team and great people around me. And I enjoy hearing the testimonies that come back from our programs when I hear someone had completed a specialization and then they went and applied for a new position, whether it's with Qualphone or somewhere else, and they got the role because of the education they received through our programs. And it just energizes me, and I want to go tell more people and shout from the rooftops and let more people know about our program.
And that's why we have you on the podcast.
Which I appreciate very much.
Well, Lyman, I appreciate you coming on, sharing your story. I find it fascinating, and telling us all about the opportunities in higher education within Qualphone. So I think it's just one of the many, many things that makes Qualphone such a unique place to work. And I thank you for sharing your story.
Happy to be on. I very much appreciate the opportunity to come on. And I'm always excited to talk to both you and Jeremy. And I will give you a little teaser. We have some new things coming down the pipe from higher education that you'll see soon. So I won't give them away. I won't spoil it, but there are some cool things coming for Qualphone from higher education in the upcoming months, for sure.
Great. We'll look forward to seeing those. And we may have to have Lyman back, Marisol.
Well, he's going to have to spot check me on my stairways.
Absolutely. Anytime.
Great. Thanks, Lyman.
Jeremy, another episode. I feel like I'm on my way to a total vocation right now, because I didn't know that I wanted to do podcasting. I mean, as a profession, but it's definitely a joy to do. So thank you, Jeremy, for being my partner on this.
Thank you. And it is great to be able to do something that you enjoy so much as part of your job. I think that's great.
Thank you to all our guests, Lyman Beatty included. And we already have like 5 people lined up for our upcoming podcast. So we have a lot of great content coming up. So make sure to subscribe on whichever podcast platform you listen to your podcast on. And if you can rate and review us on Apple, that will help with our statistics. So thank you very much.
Thanks for listening to this episode of Mission Qualphone. Remember, you can find us wherever you listen to podcasts. Please subscribe. And we'll see you next time on Mission Qualphone.